Hello, I am Professor Kino, and welcome to my Office of Cinematic Antiquity. Today we will be talking about... I have seen the trailer for this film a lot, and every time I do, I notice that the entire marketing campaign banks on one, or I guess two, things. The Russo brothers. Hot off of their financial and critical double whammy of Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame, the Russo brothers have declared that they are not going to be directing any more Marvel films, and 21 Bridges is the first step in following through on that declaration. While they did not direct 21 Bridges, the fact that they are signed on as producers, something that the trailer makes sure to emphasize, and the fact that Marvel's own T'Challa, aka Black Panther, Chadwick Boseman, plays the film's lead, pretty much made this a Russo Brothers film, at least in the eyes of the public. Something that the marketing team for this film clearly thought was its biggest pull factor, hence the Russos and Boseman being everywhere in the trailers, and the actual director, Brian Kirk, being next to nowhere in them. So does this first post-MCU Russo light endeavor show promise for the Infinity War Endgame directors' future outside of the Marvel franchise? Premise. After arriving at the crime scene of a massive shootout involving a multitude of cops and a few masked gunmen, NYPD Detective Andre Davis makes the extreme and controversial decision to close down Manhattan by blocking off its 21 bridges in order to flush out the cop-killing culprits. However, as the manhunt escalates throughout the long night, Andre stumbles upon some strange and unexpected clues and comes to some surprising revelations that makes him question everything he thought he knew about the case and the police force. Whereas all the MCU films that the Russo brothers directed, the Winter Soldier, Civil War, Infinity War, and Endgame, were intricate, boundary-pushing undertakings, 21 Bridges is, simply put, not. It's basic, and this fact stifles the film's good aspects. The first of these is namely Chadwick Boseman's strong, although occasionally dry, performance as the lead detective Andre Davis. Boseman gives the character his all and really puts effort into making him seem well-rounded and in-depth, but the whole performance hangs itself on a single piece of character development that is revealed within the opening scenes and fails to be developed any further over the next hour and a half. And what makes this lack of character development even more frustrating is that, despite Boseman's determination to make the linchpin of Davis's character worthwhile, and he does a solid job at doing just that, it is nowhere near original. Andre Davis is just a detective who, when he was a kid, lost his father to the police force and has thus devoted his life to defending the law and capturing cop killers. And Andre's unfortunately basic and unoriginal core is a disservice to Boseman's acting commitment. And this is a problem that 21 Bridges' story imposes on all of its characters, and by association, actors. Most only have a single piece of character development to them. One's a mother, one lost his brother in the Middle East and was himself dishonorably discharged, etc., etc. And this narratively minimalist flaw crops up again and again throughout the film's entirety. For example, despite an intriguing setup in Act 1, an equally fascinating premise, and a really captivating subplot involving the primary cop-killing culprits, which helps to blur the lines between good and bad by adding a gray area to the film, the following two acts and the twists featured within them betray all of the film's initial potential. Why? Because the film quickly simplifies itself into a by-the-numbers cop-gunman thriller with a core plot that has been done hundreds of times to much better effect. Let me see, it's been done in multiple James Bonds, a couple of Mission Impossibles, and quite relevantly in this case, within the MCU via the Russo brothers' own Captain America the Winter Soldier. And while the plot here is not poorly done in any way, and there is plenty of good acting and exciting action to keep the film watchable, the whole thing just feels, particularly after its interesting setup and other similarly fascinating early elements, like an unfortunately unexciting missed opportunity. So if you are itching to see a solid enough cop thriller, 21 Bridges will do the trick. But if you were hoping like I was to see the powerful and jaw-dropping storytelling provided by the Russo brothers' previous films, you will probably walk away disappointed. Thanks for watching, I hope you liked it. If you did, leave a like. If you want to add anything, feel free to leave a comment. If you want to see more, please subscribe. Until next time, I am Professor Kino, and I look forward to our next discussion.